Welcome to my channel Acreates, the channel where I share my knowledge of making games on the platform. This week I will explain how you can use styles in Game Maker Studio 2 to speed up your process. For this tutorial I would like to use Lime2's free asset folder Siren Village, which you can find on itch.io. After downloading I'm just going to open a new folder, just click on drag and drop, assign a new name, and open a new window. Now we are ready to use the tile sheet. Before we can create a tile set, we need to import the sprites. So create sprite, click on import, search for the folder, just remember to unzip it, click on the Serene Village revamp map and select Serene Village 2x32. Now you should have this tile sheet in front of you. Rename it if you want and we are ready to go. We can now create a tile set, so create tile set and assign a new sprite that we just made. As you can see, GameMaker already used the tile properties with 16x16, but we want to use 32x32. On the right side you can change all the properties, but in this case we are fine with just using the tile with 32x32. With these settings we can just already go to our first room, double click on it. Now we can create a new tile layer and we can select the new tile set 1. Now you can select one tile by one tile and just make up a nice scenery, or select multiple tiles at once to create a block of different images together. This is already a very amazing way to fill up your scenery, but as you see, the tile set also provide brushes and libraries, so we're going to look into those as well. Click on the asset tab to get back on your tile set, double click on it. Brush Builder makes selecting different objects easier. So for example, if you want the trees all together in top, you can do that. Or we can use it to modify different objects. For example, if I want the bridge bigger, I can just add parts on the bridge. And this will be the new bridge. I like to use the Brush Builder to just arrange all my stuff in an orderly way for myself, but you can just do it whatever, it doesn't really matter. It's just a great way to enhance your own workflow. Let's go back with dragging the middle mouse button and click on tile animation. And I really love this, and it's just very simple. You just set the number of frames. For example, we want that this flower is changing every time to different colors. Or we can just add an animation with two huge road signs that just swaps from left to right. For both animation, you can just set your own desirable frames per second, like the speed, and you can test the speed by just pressing on the play button. And now we are going to look at auto tiling, which is a bit more advanced. Auto tiling in GameMaker has two presets, the 47 tile set or the 16 tile set. We are going to use the 16 tile set, click on it. Now you see all the 16 tile set presets that GameMaker used to make a preset auto tiling map. Yes, it is really confusing, and I just find out that you need just to understand two things. Decide what is your base texture, like in this case we are going to use grass as our base texture, and our other texture, that is the background, the ground. All the corresponding light gray will be grass and the other parts will be ground. So this makes that this tile should be this one and that tile should be that one. And this one is for as the grass is below, and this one is when the grass is on top. These two should also be not hard. This is this one and this one is this. And this is the grass on the side on the left and this one on the right. And these are for the corners, so the left corner, the right corner, and the bottom. And these two we keep blank because we don't use them in this style sheet. Now we can go back to the room and check our new toys. When you click on the objects on the brushes, it auto tiles the different objects. And with one click, you just add trees or bridges in the scene. We can find our auto tiling at auto tile librarian and just drag in our new auto tile. Whee. As you can hear, I really love this auto tiling. And with the right mouse button, you can create the dirt bag. As you notice, when we just dragging the tree, it is like very ugly on the scene, but you can just create a new layer and just place trees and other objects, smaller objects, on the other layer. So just click on the tile set and just now you can just place on trees and other small objects in the scene without any problem. Have fun with making your unique scene. If you like this video, share some love and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Next week I will show how to create an RPG based health and mana system in Game Maker. Have a nice week, create more, enjoy more.